What's going on, Mortex Sir here, and today is all about AetherSX2. The early access has been released this morning and I'm going to put it through its paces. I'm going to show you how to install it, what the best settings are, and run a few games. So the first thing we need to do is go onto the App Store and download it. So let's just download it now for you. So once it's downloaded, we can open this up. So as you can see here, it gives you a little guide. So we're going to press next, and this is all the disclaimers and so forth about BIOS. No BIOS actually come with this. You have to have the original PS2 BIOS, which I already have. If you haven't, Google is your friend. Just saying, I didn't say that. So we're going to go with optimal, and we're going to import our BIOS. So we need to find out where our BIOS are. So mine is on the BIOS. Let's do this, and let's go for the most up-to-date one. The next one is to add our game directory. Okay, so we're going to click in this and go back to my PS2 and go on to ROMs, and we'll just click that, and then we'll just use this folder. Now that's going to calculate and catalog all our games, so our subdirectory. We press next, and then it's going to do its magic and it compiles it, and that's it. So now we are going to move on to the actual settings and what this device emulator, as I should say, can do. So we've got your general things: disk, playlist, executables, start BIOS. The main thing we need to go into is app settings. Now these are all your general ones. You want to keep fast boot on. And then we move over to system. So what I've actually found is if we go onto cycle rate and we put this -1 and also put this up to moderate, this is what the official Discord advises as well, the actual creator, to get a better speed. So we're going to test this out. Enable fastmint as well, always keep that on. Now we're going to go onto graphics. Now it works on two different settings. We've got OpenGL and we've got Vulkan. OpenGL works a lot better for me, but Vulkan may work better for you on certain games, as you'll see. So we've got all your general settings down here. We're going to put show our video frames per second, show the speed, and we'll also put show the resolution on there. So we can use the GPU palette conversion as well, and the preloaded textures. Now we don't have to, but I would always recommend putting these both on. Audio, I keep it as it is. Game list as it is. Keep this, and then advanced, and that's got all the good stuff on there if you want to play around with that. Control wise, we've got the control settings. Now you can do a single analog pad, which I like to do for touchscreen, or we can go dual analog or digital. The gamepad actually works, so we can change the buttons up. I haven't tried the gamepad yet, but I will be putting it through its paces. The phone I am running is a Goolge Pixel 5, and I've got to say, it runs perfect. Okay, so the first one we are going to try is Warriors. Now I know this is a quite intense game, it's quite big as well, so we'll see how this runs first. So as you can see in the top right corner, we've got the frames per second. We've also got the speed of the emulator and what it's running at. I absolutely love playing this game. I can remember when it first came out and I was like, oh my god, as if they're bringing a game out like this. It's one of Rockstar's most underrated games, I would say, and it doesn't get enough appreciation like it should. So as you can see, the game runs really smooth. There's not really any bugs or anything like that. We're getting a constant frames per second around 50 plus, and it's running at full speed. What we're going to do now is we're going to move on to a different game. So we've got a couple of options here. We've got change disk if we run a multi-disc game. We've also got exit game, and we've also got restart console. So what I'm going to do is just exit the game. You can also load and save it, which is great as well. So the next one we will move on to is SSX Tricky. So let's load this one up. This is one of my all-time favorite PS2 games. I'm not gonna lie, I absolutely rinsed this when it came out and tried to get the top score in every single mode. See, on this we are getting 60 frames per second. It's dropping a bit in speed, not gonna lie, it is fluctuating, but as you can see, it's really playable. The audio does dip in every now and again, but As I say, this is early access, so this is just an early preview of what this application will be able to do. Okay, that's enough of SSX. The next game we're going to move on to is Scareface. As I mentioned, because it's in early access, some of the games actually don't run, and this is a prime example of it. Scareface, the world is yours. I have numerous problems getting it to run on my virtual emulation system on the PC anyway. At the best of times, it's just one of them games that decides it doesn't want to run. So don't worry if you run into any bugs like this. The next one we will do is we'll go into the path of Neo. Okay, now this is where we run into some slight problems on this game. We are running it on the Vulcan, and as you can see, we are maxing out 20 frames per second with the speed running low at 35. As you can see, we cannot do anything at all. We can move around a bit, but that's it. So what we do here is, this is the time when we need to play around with the GPU settings. So the first thing I'm going to do is change this to OpenGL, and I'll show you what happens. Okay, now we're hitting 60 frames per second, but the rendering graphics of the game are not rendering correctly. So we don't want to save it, but we'll save it anyway. And this is a great thing to notice as well. When you save it in the actual emulator, you get a little notification that it's actually writing it and saving it. So you won't make any mistakes if you forget or you didn't realize you saved it. So as you can see here, we can actually play the game at 60 frames per second, but the graphics are, let's say, not there. It's like we're playing it in a ghost format, but if we change it back to Vulcan, we don't get the frames per second. So this is something, as I say, this is an early alpha build. So this is something that will be worked on, and later on down the line, hacks and tweaks will be able to get this playable more. But I just wanted to show you this, as some of the games will not run at full speed, or if they do, there are certain glitches and graphical errors currently. For an alpha, it's absolutely amazing. It's so fluent. Some of the games are not going to work, I'm not going to lie guys, so don't expect every single game to work, but some of the more intense games that I've tried out do actually work and they run really well. A couple of recommendations that I would advise is go into the GPU settings, try OpenGL or Vulcan if you're not getting the right speed. Change some of the settings, do a couple of tweaks and see how you get on with that. This is a work in progress. So there will be updates. If you want to join the Discord community, the link is down below. There's a lot of people in the community finding ways to improve the games that they're running, or let you know what games run and what games don't currently. I will be doing a more in-depth test on different games, because this is only a couple of games on the library that I put in, so you can sort of see the difference on games. So that's the PS2 emulator on Android. It's an amazing device for an early access bit of a kit. My name has been Mortex Sir. If you do like this kind of content, please give me the thumbs up, like and rate, and drop a comment down below. Let me know what your thoughts are on this, and if you've actually got this working, what games have you been playing? Have you found any tricks to improve the graphical settings so it runs a lot smoother? Let me know in the comments down below. As always, we've got various other videos on the channel that are down there now. But until next time, guys, stay safe, and I'll see you all soon.